So now in this section we will see the big data and e-governance. So the use and adoption of big data within governmental processes is beneficial and allows the efficiencies in terms of cost, productivity and innovation. Means we can say that it does not come, that is, we can say that process does not come without its flaws. But as big data is widely used and it is need of era and it is having its own highest efficiency capabilities, so it allows the efficiency and it is beneficial in terms of cost, productivity and innovation, and that's why the use and adoption of big data is done in the governmental processes. So data analysis often requires multiple parts of government, that is central and local, to work in collaboration and create new and innovative processes to deliver the desired outcome. So we can take examples that over the last two decades there has been a dramatic shift regarding the notion of citizens' right. We know that there are definitely the lot of changes has been done in the citizens' right to information. So we can take that examples. Now the right to information is considered as a right that all human beings should have, and ultimately government is considered for what? Government is considered as a right, government is considered as the guardian of all this public information. So in other countries the relationship between Indian citizens and government is mediated by ICT, okay, that is information communication technologies. So this system introduced the concept of open government data, and that led to the adoption of RTI, which provided a unique opportunity for citizens so that they can access the governmental data. So this development led to an increased demand for data digitalization actually. With the ICT providing the digital opportunity to modernize and government to modernize the government and create the digital democracy. So the ICT initiative, the National E-Governance Plan, that is NEGP, and its institutional framework has been successful in providing the timely service, eradicating corruption and reaching those who had previously not having access at the lower cost. And the data collected from social media sites, e-commerce websites, e-government, online services and sensor networks comprise a significant part of data which is stored and transmitted over the internet using what? Using the cloud infrastructure. So this data is growing at an exponential rate, we know, because every one of us are using these things. This huge volume of data is turned into information which can be utilized for both economic and social benefits of citizens, enterprises, governmental and public sector organization. It is actually very challenging to manage such huge volume of data without big data framework, advanced technology and data researchers actually. So the e-governance is using all these ICT technologies for providing the citizens, business, society and other government non-government agencies with efficient, cost-effective and effective manner. So the study of state of big data infrastructure is having that there is a dry future performance relief for all the organizations, and because of that they are having the successful big data project implementation. Despite the challenges, majority of Indian organizations have the process of adapting big data strategies, since the benefits are clearly there with though the challenges are there. So there is a huge potential of big data technologies in India, and this is a high growth economy and organizations which depend on insights from raw data to plan the future course. More than 60% of organizations are having the big data and they are using it as the large volumes of unstructured data. The Indian government utilizes numerous techniques how the Indian electorate is responding to government action as well as the policy augmentation. So all the governments are using this big data fashion because it is used by using very much care. So improving the service delivery, big data technology are helping local and state agencies which for providing the timely, accurate, complete and customizable information to their employees, residents as well as business. Analysis of these systems can help officials for anticipating the problems like traffic jam or transit related things. In fact, these are helpful for nutrition, crime, obesity, employment, drug safety and healthcare etc., which delivers the best services, and because of that the decision making system is higher because that is helping in the mission. In USA also, the big data research and development initiatives are taken from 2012, and almost the initiative is composed of 84 big data programs and which is spread across almost 6 departments. In Facebook, they are handling almost 50 billion photos from its users, and they are handling all such big data analysis which is playing the biggest and largest role. In fact, that has big data analysis played a large role in Barack Obama's 2012 re-election campaign also. And because of that, the United States federal government owns 6 of the 10 most powerful supercomputers in the world. So these are the benefits of big data, and that's why all the governments are adopting and using this big data with the governmental processes. So this is all about big data and e-governance that we have seen. Though we know its advantages, but in the next section, we will see the benefits of big data in detail. Thank you.